What's up, everybody? The Poets here. I hope you're staying well, staying at home, and staying safe. Crazy times right now, and you definitely want to check on your friends and family, especially the ones that are used to going out all the time. They're probably struggling a little bit more than others. So the point of this video is talking about COVID-19 and what's going on with folding at home. So I've made a couple of videos so far on folding at home. The first one was kind of like an introduction, what it's all about, what the project is about, how it's helping to find cures, or basically enhance the research for things like Alzheimer's, you know, cancer, other specific viruses. And my second video really talked on helping with the whole COVID-19, beer virus, human malware stuff that's happening. Basically, you could use folding at home if you select any for what project you want to use. Sometimes you would get some work units that really focused on COVID-19. Now, as of today, this filming is April 17th, the Folding at Home project did release a nice update. Basically, they fixed some bugs that they had in the software. They have now allowed for you to select specifically COVID-19 as the main project you want your computer to be working on. And then, of course, they have really fixed a number of bugs, and they said some sort of security issues that they had. Nothing big, and they're focused on putting everything out there in terms of an open source area as well. So they actually have a GitHub and some volunteers that are working really hard to fixing any additional bugs in the future that may come up. So they're being very transparent with this, which is really nice. And so to get this update, very simple. Just go to the Folding at Home website, which is foldingathome.org. And up top, you'll see news. So just click on news. So here, as of April 17th, you're gonna see the newest article that they have, which is talking about COVID-19. So just click on read more, very short article. But basically, in the article, they're giving thanks to some of their volunteers that have really helped them out, as well as the Center for the Science and Engineering of Living Systems. So there's a lot of organizations, a lot of groups that have worked hard to make folding at home a really solid project. And so with this new update, basically you just hit here, or just in the normal download section, you can also download the update there. But it's good to kind of read this short article. And with that, when you first install it, you're going to see this web interface right here. I don't really like using the web interface, but it is the first thing that pops up. You will see the drop down right here where it says you want to support researching for fighting any disease, COVID-19, Alzheimer's, all kinds of stuff here. So before, if you had any disease selected, at that point you would be able to help with all the projects and of course be open to COVID-19. Now with COVID-19 selected, you're going to be able to use your CPU and your GPU at the same time to help with this project. So I hope everybody kind of looks into this. This is a wonderful thing. If you're not really familiar with folding at home, please take a look at my previous two videos on this. There's a lot of good detail there. So now I'm going to kind of get into a bit of a Q&A as a lot of people, we had almost immediately like 20,000 views on my beer virus, fight the virus video. So there were a lot of questions as well. One of the main ones was how do you select maybe your CPU or GPU within the Folding at Home software? So this is the web interface you'll see up top right here, but I like to go to the advanced control area. To get to that, you just kind of go to your Folding at Home, right click on it, and you will then get an option to have this pop up, which is the advanced control. So the advanced control just kind of gives you more information about everything that's happening with your computer. And so if you go to configure and slots in this area, you can select GPU and CPU. So you can remove one, you can have both there. This area here for CPU, what I have is the Threadripper 3970X. So it's 32 cores, 64 threads. The Folding at Home project only goes up to 32 threads, all right? Not 32 cores, 32 threads. So if I wanted to specifically use all 64 threads that I have, I would have to have one CPU here for selected as 32. So if I go to edit here, you'll see here that right now I have it set to 16 threads because I was doing some other stuff, but I could have that up to 32, and then I can add a second one here, add another CPU, and put that as 32 threads as well. So then I would have the full 64 threads of my Threadripper being able to be used. You can also use this to help somewhat monitor the temperatures as well. So if you have a processor that you swear is just kind of running too hot for whatever reason, first and foremost, folding at home shouldn't make your processor run too hot. Okay, so that's probably going on with something else, like maybe your thermal compound, so or maybe an overclock. So I'll touch on that in a second. But you can actually do what I did here, which is reduce the number of threads. So I have 16 threads going on here, as you see, even though I have 64 threads available. So with my Threadripper, if I'm, say, you know, gaming or doing a video editing project or something, I can still have this running without the GPU running. So I'm still running folding at home with 16 threads going, and I'm not generating a lot of heat or a lot of electricity. So I'm still contributing, which is quite nice, but I'm able to still have, you know, all of my other projects or any gaming I want to have going on. But if I want to really crank this out, I'll put two CPUs there, both with 32 threads, and I'm good to go as well. Some of the comments that I had in previous video were, can I use my laptop to contribute? The answer is easily yes. Basically, you have on average about 8 days to complete a work unit. So whether you're using a 64 thread, you know, beast of machine, or a laptop like this Microsoft Surface Laptop 3, as long as you get those work units done within on average 8 days, it completes, you're contributing, all right? So some projects will say, hey, this only has a 3-day time limit because they need to, you know, get the numbers in. Some may say 10, but the average is about 8 days. So as long as you're seeing when you're running these on a laptop that you're actually completing the work units, you're contributing, thank you very much. We love you for that. A question that's asked fairly often is, hey, folding at home is making my computer really loud, or it looks like my CPU is getting really, really hot. The answer to that is kind of mixed. So the folding at home software shouldn't overheat your PC. If you feel that your PC is kind of overheating, there could be a couple of different reasons. One, you might need to replace your thermal compound. So this is just a Z390, Z370 motherboard. I don't know, doesn't matter, Z370 motherboard. But you can see here that the IHS has some thermal compound on there. That's an aftermarket thermal compound, because the stock thermal compound that tends to come with a lot of you know, pre-built PCs, they're not all that good. Or if you're just buying some off-the-shelf thermal compound, it probably has a heat transfer rating of maybe like 2 or 3. I really like Thermal Grizzly's Cryonaut. This is really, really good because this has a thermal transfer rate of 12.5. So you'll see, you know, people like Der Bauer, Gamers Nexus, you know, all kinds of well-known overclockers that, you know, use Thermal Grizzly. I've been using this for many, many years, and it's served me very, very well. So basically all you do is kind of take off your heatsink. There tends to be just 4 screws right here. Take it off, leave the IHS on, just kind of clean it off with some, you know, rubbing alcohol, apply just a little bit. You don't need a lot. Right to it. If you want me to do a video on this, I will be happy to do a video on this. Underneath this IHS, I actually have liquid metal because I've been overclocking this exact PC for a while. And so that's separate. So never put liquid metal on top of the IHS. So if you're going to use liquid metal that goes underneath, that's a whole delidding process. But the Cryonaut, you know, this thermal compound goes right on top. And then you put your heat sink or your water block right on top of that. That should greatly improve your temperatures if you've never touched this thermal compound on your PC before. It's an easy fix. This is like 10 to 20 bucks, depending on how much you buy. But so I'll put links below for stuff like that. So easy, easy fix right there. Another issue you could have is just airflow within the PC. So in my system right here, this is the, you know, Threadripper 3970X. It has 3 radiators in there. For all the fans I have in there, I use Be Quiet's fans. I love Be Quiet's fans. A lot of people like Noctua's fans. These are some of the best, in my opinion, in terms of generating incredible heat transfer and being very, very quiet as well. So you can barely even tell that my PC is on, besides all the blingy RGB. So these are some of my favorites. I'll put links to both of these in the comments below. Another explanation why a PC could be overheating is just there's just too much dust inside of there. And I say that because there are a lot of non-tech enthusiasts that got really, really excited to use their PC to, you know, help with this whole COVID-19 research. And they may have never opened up their PC before, and therefore there's dust bunnies, you know, running around inside of there. So there have been times where I've just taken my PC, not this PC, but I've taken a PC out to the lawn with a leaf blower and just blown that stuff out of there because it's serious. Not a leaf blower, but you get my point. So clean the inside of the PC. That does greatly help with temperatures. There's plenty of YouTube videos on there where I think like Hardware Canucks did one video where they showed how much of a temperature drop they received on a PC because they just cleaned it. That's all they did. It dropped by like 8 degrees Celsius. It's nuts. So clean the PC as well. So I hope you guys are excited so that we have that drop down for COVID-19. So you can really just kind of earmark your PC power, CPU and GPU, both for COVID-19 research. Thank you very much for everything that you're doing on that. We need to get outside and socialize and hug people, all that good stuff. I have a future video coming up as well, the Galaxy Buds Plus. So if you want to know if they're worth it compared to the OG Buds, the new Buds, I love this color too. Stay tuned for that. So please feel free to like this video if you liked it. Hit that subscribe button. I really appreciate all my subscribers. Put some comments down below. I read all the comments. I try to respond to everybody. And if you have more questions on folding at home, please put those below because we need to get this word out as much as possible. So share this video, share other videos about COVID-19 research using folding at home. Thank you very much. Stay safe, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace.